In a previous video, we demonstrated how to install the baseline WaterTec S100 soil moisture sensor. In order for it to start performing its job, some initial configuration and calibration is needed. To start, the manufacturer suggests that you program your irrigation controller to run through its cycles every day of the week. The idea behind this is that the S100 will prevent unneeded irrigation cycles based on the moisture content of the soil. Obviously, this is not possible if your location has water restrictions. If you do have restricted watering days and times, then you can skip this step. To minimize water runoff, it's also advised that you use soak cycles. This means that you divide each watering cycle into two or more different periods to allow the water from the initial cycle to soak into the soil before the next round of water is applied. To configure the S100, you will first need to determine how much time is needed for the controller to complete all of its irrigation for the day. The S100 is pre-programmed for a 12-hour window, which should be enough for most applications. But if you need to increase or decrease this time, here's how. Press and hold the bypass button for 2 seconds. The current cycle window time will show on the display. While holding the bypass button, press the plus or minus button to adjust the number of hours you would like to allow for your cycle window. It's a good idea to add 1 hour to the time it takes your system to complete a daily cycle. For example, if it takes your irrigation system 6 hours to complete a daily irrigation cycle, then you should set the cycle window time to 7 hours. To determine the moisture threshold for your soil type, the S100 has an auto calibration mode. This is important for new installations and is also useful for recalibrating the sensor. Start off by saturating the soil around the sensor with water. If the soil is not properly saturated, the auto calibration will fail or give you an inaccurate result. Once the water has had sufficient time to soak in, press the read set button on the S100 to take the current moisture reading. Write down the current date, time, and moisture reading for future reference. Next, press and hold the plus, minus, and bypass buttons simultaneously for 3 seconds to begin the 24-hour calibration process. The display will indicate the hours remaining in the calibration as well as the current moisture reading. If you need to exit the auto calibration mode, press and hold the read set button for 3 seconds. If the calibration was successful, the moisture threshold will be automatically set, and the system will only allow watering when the soil moisture is below this threshold. Be aware that the irrigation cycles will be prevented while the S100 is in auto calibration mode. If the auto calibration fails, the screen will flash ER4, followed by another code with a number that corresponds to the reason for failure. See the troubleshooting section in the installation guide for information on the various error messages. Keep in mind that the calibration will either fail entirely or set an incorrect threshold if the S100 receives water during the 24-hour calibration period, or if the soil was not totally saturated. If this happens, you will need to resaturate the soil around the sensor and begin the auto calibration again. As the grass roots grow back around the sensor, you might need to manually adjust the threshold based on your observations of the health of the turf. Raising the threshold results in more frequent watering. Lowering the threshold results in less frequent watering. To make a threshold adjustment, start by briefly pressing the read set button and make a note of the current threshold for future reference. Next, press and hold the read set button while pressing the plus or minus button to increase or decrease the threshold value as needed. An adjustment of 1/2 to 1 point is all that should be necessary for most situations. To prevent the S100 from interfering with the controller's programming, press the bypass button. This is useful for manual controller operation or when overseeding. When you are done, simply press the bypass button again to enable sensor control. If you would like to learn more about the baseline WaterTec S100 soil moisture sensor, contact your local Ewing branch or visit us online at ewingirrigation.com.